So before filming, I already painted my hair white, or at least gray, using some white body paint. Now I'm taking glue stick and I'm gonna flatten down my brows by stroking in the direction of hair growth. Afterwards, I'm going to set the glue with powder and add an additional layer of glue to ensure they're down for the long run. The flatter the better, so add more layers as you see fit. After setting the glue with the final layer of powder, you're going to conceal the color of the brows using a concealer. I'm actually using a full coverage foundation by Kat Von D. You'll notice how I'm applying it very gently so as not to disturb the glue. Covering the brows and drawing on new ones is not a necessary step, but I like the transformative power. Plus, I want really thin, arched, over-exaggerated bitch brows for this look, and my natural brows are simply way too approachable. After setting that brow block with more setting powder, go ahead and apply your base. I'm using my favorite new foundation brush from Sigma. This is their 3D HD Kabuki with some more Kat Von D foundation thinned out with L'Oreal True Match. To conceal my dark circles, I'm using Benefit's Erase Paste Concealer, and finally, I'm setting my entire face. Using a bronzer of choice and a large fluffy powder brush, add shading to the cheekbones and temples with careful attention to blending. This is going to act as a transitional shade to our contour. Now take a darker contour color. I'm actually using a brown eyeshadow on a large eyeshadow blending brush. I'm deepening my contour in the hollow of my cheeks and my temples. So we're moving on to the eyes. I'm prepping the lids using MAC Softer Paint Pot. I'm taking that same paint pot on a flat concealer brush. You can use any brush with a flat belly. I'm etching out my brow highlight, and this can actually be done with any cream highlight color like a concealer or foundation. What you're actually doing is planning where you're gonna draw the brow. This helps to avoid asymmetrical brows, which is actually a mistake I make pretty often. Normally, you just work with your natural brow as a guide, but it's hard drawing new brows on a blank canvas. And as you can see, the shape I've chosen is very arched, thin, and high, kind of like if Storm is a drag queen. To create the brow, I'm using an old favorite, my MAC 266 angled brush with some Anastasia Dip Brow, which I've thinned out with a little makeup oil I had lying around since my pomade was getting dry and hard to work with after having it for so long. I like it to be quite runny so it goes on like paint, but anyway, as you can see, I like to keep the front of the brow fairly natural by drawing hair-like strokes upwards. On the eyes, we're starting off by using a light taupe transitional shadow, blending this into my crease using circular motions. It should be light enough that it's just barely darker than your skin. Continue layering that until you get visible definition. At this point, you're going to move on to a darker brown eyeshadow, stippling this on with a smaller brush so it's not messy. I'm actually using a Sigma Buff and Blend brush. And then afterwards, you're going to go back in with your original blending brush, diffusing this into your transitional shadow. And you're going to repeat this process once again with a black eyeshadow, repeating as many times as necessary until you have both intensity of the darkness and the softness by blending. Next, you're going to apply winged liner using your tool of choice. I like to use gel. On the lower lash line, I'm coloring in my waterline with the same liner I used on top, which I wouldn't really recommend if you use liquid. You could use a cool pencil, anything else. When your waterline is black, start blending black and brown shadow into the lash line, blending it until it fades effortlessly into the skin. Then you're simply going to apply your mascara and false lashes. Be sure to pick some sickening lashes. I chose a relatively natural pair because I wanted it to look glam like women's lashes and not like drag queen lashes because I'm fish. Now for the lips, I chose to opt for a new color. If I could do it over, I probably would have went for like a MAC Cyber or Sin, any bold dark lip color, but I went nude because that's what Halle Berry was wearing in my reference pictures. Of course, you can stop here if you want, but I decided to take some creative liberty and draw some lightning bolts on my face coming out from my eyes. Fun fact, I tried a look similar to this like months ago and I wasn't happy with it, so I didn't show anyone, but I wanted to revisit that concept today. What happened was that I didn't like how my lightning was so thick in my last look that I did. So the second time around, I made sure to keep them looking more thin and believable. I used a white liquid liner from NYX, being sure to apply the pressure strategically, pressing gently for thinner lines and harder for more visible ones. And with that, the makeup is done, but the Storm look is not complete without these white mesh contacts from CamoEyes.com. I'm so obsessed with these, I want to wear them like every day. Before I had these, I had like mastered the art of rolling my eyes to the back of my head so it would look like my pupils were gone. It never looked right, but now I can live my dream of a having no pupils. And on that note, the look is complete. Please like, comment, and subscribe if you like this look, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye!